Hi guys, I'm Sean. This is Alyssa.
Gus is in our hearts. And this is Internet Rabbit Hole Daily.
And I'm sure you guys know, but the trailer for Panthen just came out, or should I say the teaser for Panthen. We checked it out in another video. And then we had this...
Pathon?
Pathon.
You're saying Panthen.
Oh, okay.
It's
well,
like
let's...
a panther.
Ah!
There's no N.
I'm so bad with this. I know. Pathon. Okay, there we go. You guys can maybe let us know how to pronounce it properly down there. My apologies. We are checking out this video, though, which says... Pathon teaser review and awaited comeback, and it looks like maybe we've got some humor here. We're gonna get to see some different parts of the movie here. I don't know what to expect. I don't even know if it's in English, but it was recommended, so we're gonna check it out.
Yeah, well, I'd like to hear a little bit more about it. It pertains to his comeback because it's been 4 years.
Yeah,
said it's been a while. He did a movie.
Well, as far as I know, I saw the thumbnail that seemed to indicate that. So let's check it out.
That's what I'm talking about. That's why he's that's why he's the goat.
That's me. After I saw it. Not sure if we've ever checked this.
I remember in 2019 making a video about what could be the best comeback for Shah Rukh Khan, and even years ago,
wasn't that Hrithik Roshan on the right?
Oh yeah,
that's Hrithik Roshan on the right. It's the wrong guy.
I guess so. His perfect comeback would involve Hrithik Roshan in some way.
19 making a video about what could be the best comeback for Shah Rukh Khan, and even 3 years ago, the case still stands for the genre of film that would be ideal for his grand entry. While my suggestions included the third installment of Dawn or a joint spy universe film opposite Hrithik Roshan from War,
there you go.
The genre is
spot on, and are still wondering of how this spy universe will be connected. While Shah Rukh Khan himself
seems
to be mostly impulsive with the stories he says yes to, there seems to be a meticulous and careful thought process that has gone into making sure that 2023 is not only exciting with respect to his appearances, but also offers a wide variety of roles.
Yeah, no
Javan
kidding.
Really honing in on the mass commercial cinema Javan. That has been lacking in Bollywood other than what Rohit Shetty attempts, and the fail-safe social impactful dramas from Rajkumar Hirani. It is, however, the several elements YRF is integrating in the universe of Pathan that really makes me believe that the makers are leaving no stone unturned in expanding this universe and making sure that they have an entity people look forward to. After the disastrous 2022 for YRF with back-to-back humongous failures, it really seems like their eye has been on making 2023 one of the most memorable years at the movies with their titles. We often on this channel talk about the big cinema experience. This sense of escapism is something that really worked wonders for a film like Brahmastra despite the criticism with its content. Especially the first 2 weeks, the film accounted for the most houseful theaters with its IMAX shows. And the fact that Pathan has been shot with digital IMAX cameras made me even more stoked that the makers mean business.
Oh, that's
this
cool.
Film. Is 2023 so really IMAX going to be ready. The epic return after more than 4 years that we have been waiting for? Was most of our assessment correct that the king will rise? All of these thoughts rushed through my head as the teaser of Pathan dropped today. What a lot of people don't realize, and this is true for not only cinema enthusiasts or hardcore Bollywood fans, but there is a deep, unspoken and unanimous feeling rooting for Shah Rukh Khan to return with a bang. And the teaser really did prove that it has all the ingredients for an epic big screen cinema experience. Let's get into the nitty gritties of what I absolutely loved and
as well. Oh, this is great! He's gonna get right into all the stuff!
Below, the discourse and back and forth is going to be really interesting. The action-packed origin. I absolutely loved the first few rushes of the teaser. Looking at an agent who has been caught on a mission and is in solitary confinement of sorts in another country.
You have an expectation of his initial portions being how he escapes from the establishment,
and it showcases at least glimpses of a really adrenaline-filled start to the journey. I love that they have gone for the unkempt long hair and beard look for Shah Rukh Khan, as it makes me reminisce about the Dawn 2 introduction set piece, and how it absolutely had the ground running from the very first frame. It's going to be one action set piece after the other, and one of my biggest criticisms for a guilty pleasure film like War was that some of its explanations of how characters lined up where they...
If you guys are watching and don't know, we reacted to War, the whole movie.
Oh, yeah, that's true. So every single scene.
We have a playlist for that. We will link it in the description.
That.
You're going to want to check that out.
And since you pause things, I'll turn off my alarm here, telling me that I might need to get ready for work here. Okay, there we go.
they did was rather farcical, but I hope that the screenplay for a film like
it was a little farcical. That's maybe a way to put it.
I liked it.
That this is a come up from the demerits of a film in the same spy universe, and it just gets better and better. Deepika having stake in the matter.
So it's in the same spy universe.
Is it actually? It actually is supposed to be.
I didn't know there was a confirmation.
Like, are the war characters gonna show up for a little cameo potentially? You know, and
potentially, I have a feeling.
How do we know it's the same spy universe?
Because this guy's telling us.
Because he knows.
Because he knows.
He did his research.
I don't know how he knows, but he does.
What was also one of the most talked about aspect for a film of the magnitude and scale like Brahmastra was that the female characters did not have a stake in the matter. Vani Kapoor.
Wait, is it in the Brahmastra universe?
Sequences, and Alia was mostly he's just comparing Shiva throughout the journey. But what I love about the rushes regarding Deepika Padukone is that she is portrayed as a character getting her hands dirty.
Those earrings look so heavy.
Making me think that she will have more to do with the mission at hand. Just like Katrina Kaif did with Tiger Zinda Hai or what Ana de Armas did with No Time to Die.
I haven't seen either of those films.
This is what I have James
for people
Bond.
Portraying female characters as only romantic interests. And I love that Deepika is going to be indulging in several action set pieces. John as the antagonist. One of the most interesting decisions taken with this film as being part of the spy universe is that John Abraham is the antagonist, and we will see this avatar only after Dhoom and Race 2. The face-off between him and Pathaan will definitely account for a frame I'm really stoked to witness on the big screen, and one of the biggest demerits for a film like War was that it had an extremely weak antagonist before the face-swapping twist, and I love that they have gone
the
for face stars swap.
That was the best.
I forgot about that.
As his ammunition.
How could you forget?
That visuals was... and background music seems high octane. I absolutely love the background score that was present in the initial portions and the concluding moments of this teaser. There are some moments from the teaser, I won't lie, that can be
nitpicked
as some of the visual effects may not have superimposed the characters as well as they should have in the digitally created backdrops that have been designed. But I have to say that if the bang for the buck is that you're going for a high octane, adrenaline-filled action film meant for the big screens, then Pathaan really is serving the same. I hope in the pursuit of mass elements, Siddharth Anand has integrated the cameos well in this film, because if there is a possibility that both Tiger and Kabir will be in this film, then you know there's no stopping this film.
Oh, that would be way too much fun.
One of the biggest bangers from Bollywood in 2023. And that was a video, guys. Write down in the comments below what you thought about the teaser.
Salman, that was Salman Khan.
Handles right in front
at
of you.
The end, he showed
Jammy
the photo. Is he in the spy universe too?
The like button,
we got a lot to figure out, don't we? I'm not sure. Sure, there seems to maybe there's this larger universe that we're just sort of dipping our toes into the water on at this junction. I hadn't heard that this was in any way connected to any other movie. So we're gonna have to look to you guys to maybe fill in some of the blanks here. I guess we're a little late to the party. I certainly think it would be cool if it was tied into a larger universe. This isn't certainly the first Indian film that we've seen do this, where they have sort of movies that aren't necessarily sequels per se, but they're sort of connected in some way.
The antagonist in this, that actor, we saw the trailer. He was in a few trailers, maybe. Like, there wasn't one, like, some type of... It reminded me of Iron Man. It was almost like he was this robot spy thing, too.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking, like,
could be
part of the universe? And it's like, is he the same character but playing the antagonist?
Well, we are going to have to get some clarification here before we get too far ahead of ourselves. Maybe you guys can let us know. Is this speculation that this might be connected to War? Is this a confirmed thing? Are there other movies that are part of this sort of War universe? Or?
Is he saying spy universe as in like spy
genre?
Yeah,
I don't know. But I have a feeling that someone in our comment section might know. And if you guys are as enthused for this movie as we are and would like us to check out even more related to it and SRK, then
click the subscribe button, click the bell, choose the all from the drop down so you get those notifications when we upload, and click the thumbs up. You always do it at the wrong spot.
I know. What the heck?
Click the thumbs up. You liked it, and comment down below. Answer our questions. Our many questions.
Thank you to Tried and Refused Productions for putting together such a great video. I've heard of these folks before, but I think it's our first time checking out a video, and I have a feeling we'll be checking out even
his
more.
His name's Jenny V. Kapoor, I think. I think that's him there.
Oh, okay.
He did an interview with
I don't know. Either way, we love you guys a whole lot. This is In That Rabbit Hole Daily, R8
signing off.
Bye. Bye, guys.